coordinates are set for the MK core. Time to see what all the fucking fuss is about. With the fuel you found, we should have no problem getting there, and back to Ganymede at least.
And how is the new prosthetic?
It'll do. Get some rest, Captain. No telling what we'll find at those coordinates.
It's been a rough week. I should check in with the crew and see how everyone's doing. The one thing I know about Virgil is at least we've only had one limb replacement so far. You're welcome, Rayan. Say what you will about Virgil, but he takes his job as ship's medic very seriously. True belters take water, air, and sleep wherever they can find them. Say anything else about these two, but they are true belters. Whatever Cox was saying about Virgil's past clearly upset him. I need to know what it was about.
What's on your mind, Captain?
I found some mushroom powder for you to cook with.
Bursting with umami. exceptional. Thank you, Captain.
Cox said you were hiding something. Something that Belters wouldn't like.
Cox is a habitual liar. First, he tried to murder you. Then he tried to deflect blame onto me.
So there's nothing else you wish to share? Nothing you're hiding?
No, Captain. No more than anyone else on this ship.
Get some rest, Virgil.
Will do, Captain.
Hey, Cod.
Resting. Go away.
Can you believe how vicious these pirates are?
Yes.
I mean, how they were willing to blow us up just to prove a point.
Yes.
So you don't think there's anything special about them?
Yes, I do. They seem to have more guns.
Any guesses on our destination?
Nada. All I know is that it's far the fuck out there. So whoever hid that treasure wanted it far the fuck away.
Good talking to you, Khan.
Yeah.
What are you listening to?
It's Martian music. You wouldn't like it.
I'll decide what I like and don't like.
Look for me. Slowly take my chance. I never kiss your lips, never see you smile, never hear your voice, never touch your face.
Well,
it's a beautiful song.
My mom used to play it for us on the guitar. Half the time, she'd break down crying and not even finish it. It reminded her of my dad. It's funny. I hate my dad. I hate the army he died for. And I hate Mars. But I still miss it.
Khan seemed pleased with her prosthetic.
That's good. Although you realize we just took the most unhinged person on the ship and gave her a bionic skull crusher for an arm.
I think if Khan wanted to kill someone, she could do it without arms or legs.
What you did in the debris field was incredibly reckless. You disobeyed my order. And you put the whole...
Oh my god. You're fucking welcome.
I was getting to that. Thank you.
Anytime.
I'll leave you to it then.
Wait. About that moment in the airlock.
Yes?
Are you feeling any better? I know you were pretty scared given how tightly you were holding my hand.
I'm pretty sure you grabbed my hand in there.
Oh, sure. We can go with that if you want. I'm just saying, I'm here if you need to talk.
The only thing we need to talk about is your delusion of fantasizing about me.
I get it. It must be hard for the boss Meng to express her feelings. Especially to the hot Martian engineer who can totally kick your ass.
Not according to that scoreboard.
My point is, there's nothing to be embarrassed about. Even if you did clink helmets with me.
Clink helmets? What is that supposed to mean?
I think you know exactly what it means. Helmet clinker.
Typical dumb Martian. You try to kiss a woman but forget to take your helmet off first.
If I did try to kiss you, there'd be no fucking confusion about it. You know, we could stand here talking about hands and helmets all night. Or we could go back to my room and settle it.
By settle it, are you talking about sex?
Only one way to find out.
Wow. So this is where that missing barbecue sauce went. Cox doesn't seem too bothered by his demotion. Cox.
Are you here to let me out?
Then kindly fuck off. Captain.
Honestly, I'm glad Maya finally got one. This was starting to get sad. If I sleep with Maya, the entire crew will know about it. Nothing stays secret on a ship like this. Is one night worth all the drama? Definitely.
Fucking finally. When Cox sat us down in the mess hall, I thought you were dead. And today, in the airlock, I thought we were dead.
I know.
I'm just saying, you're not allowed to die on me, Kamina Drummer. Because I'm not losing the one person in the belt I give a shit about.
Captain, you're going to want to see this.
There's nothing on the map. No record of any settlements. So what the fuck is that?
If you are receiving this message, it means you've found us at last. You've come, and with you comes the next great step in the evolution of humanity. We have been preparing for your arrival for years, perhaps centuries. We have been patient. We know you have much to teach us. If you can hear my voice, whoever you are, welcome home.
It just repeats after that.
Who was that?
The head of the station, presumably.
Whoever he was, he's long gone now. Generations ago, millions of Earthers tried to set up mining stations in the Belt. Some of them lasted. Some died off right away. And some of them, no one knows.
Still, a station this large, uncharted, and seemingly uninhabited? It's like nothing I've heard of.
What did the initial scans tell us?
None of the scanners penetrate past the first level. But there are no heat signatures, no activity, except this broadcast. Looks clear.
Maybe. But we don't know who stashed it here. Or who else they might have told about it.
Not to mention, how the fuck are we gonna find it in there? The place is massive.
There was a line in the coordinates. Something about the first ones.
Fuck does that mean?
Won't know till we get inside. Arlen, Rayan, stay on the ship. Be ready to burn hard if there's any activity on the radar.
Sure thing, boss man. Good hunting.
Maya and I will head inside and search around.
Exactly how old is this place?
Too old to be on any maps. Maybe 100 years?
Damn. This is fucking strange.
Let's search for the command center.
Found it! Over here.